गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, माय नेम इज पूनमून एंड आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ रिव्यू पेपर ऑन द टॉपिक यूज ऑफ नैनो पार्टिकल्स फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ लैटर फिंगरप्रिंट। कैन वी मूव फॉर द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। सो इज द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट, द एडवांसेस इन नैनो पार्टिकल्स हैव वास्ट एप्लीकेशंस इन द फील्ड ऑफ फॉरेंसिक साइंस सच एज इन सिक्योरिटी डॉक्यूमेंट्स, पेंट examination of things, chemicals and toxins, DNA analysis, lab on chips, among others. They have also proved to be useful for the development of latent fingerprints. Distinct rich details can be obtained by applying different nanoparticles such as gold, silver, silicon dioxide, zinc oxide, aluminum oxide, etc. Latent fingerprint evidence are one of the important evidences found in many crimes. The use of new and better techniques may enable the development of fingerprints even on seemingly difficult substrates. This review focuses on different nanoparticles and their applications in development of latent fingerprints. Next slide, please. So basically, fingerprints which we found on crime scene are of three types: latent, patent, and plastic prints. Out of the all three, the most common type of fingerprints that we encounter on crime scene are the latent fingerprints, which are invisible. So different powder methods and chemical techniques have been used for the development of these fingerprints. And the other two fingerprints are visible to us from a naked eye. So nanoparticles can also is the another method which we can use for the development of latent fingerprints. Nanoparticles are small particles that range between 1 to 100 nanometers in size, which are undetectable to the human eye. Nanoparticles can exhibit significantly different physical and chemical properties to their larger material counterparts. They have a vast application in the field of forensic science for the analysis of trace evidence such as examination of blood stains, ink, paint, security documents, fingerprints, and etc. So, in a study of Mathias et al., in their study, they have shown a new possibility for the development of latent fingerprints on non-porous surfaces. They have used gold nanoparticles stabilized by an alkaline thiol chain and dissolved in petroleum ether, which adhere to the fingerprint material and enhance the development of latent fingerprints by the silver physical development method. In the picture, you can see there is a fingerprint which is divided into two parts. The upper portion was developed with the help of silver physical development, and the second part was developed by gold nanoparticles followed by silver physical development method. In the next study done by Vandana et al., they have done a comparative study between silver nitrate and silver nitrate nanoparticles. Comparatively, when silver nitrate was used as a developing agent for the latent fingerprint, only faint rich patterns were observed, which further showed degradation of fingerprint stability within about 20 days. Overall, the current silver nanoparticle method showed good visibility and stability by using lower concentration of silver nitrate, which can be used in place of conventional silver nitrate method. Then in other study, we have found that zinc oxide nanoparticles were used in the form of nanopowder for developing the aged latent fingerprints on non-porous surfaces. The developed fingerprint exhibit distinguishable rich details with fluorescence under UV light as portrayed in the figure. In the figure, you can see a 10-day-old fingerprint on glass surface, which was developed by using zinc oxide nanopowder. The new combination of nanopowder consisting of zinc oxide and silica dioxide has been found to be effective in developing the latent fingerprint on various nanoporous non-porous surfaces. In another study, we have found that gold nanoparticles play a significant role in the development of latent fingerprint because of their inert nature, high selectivity and sensitivity, and attributes which enable the storage of the developed fingerprint for the prolonged period of time. The gold nanoparticles were used to enhance the visibility of the latent fingerprint by multi-metal deposition, which involves a two-step cold gel method. The fingerprint bearing surface was immersed in the solution of gold nanoparticles, which was stabilized in citrate iron medium, followed by the addition of silver physical developer solution. Characterization was done by using UV visible spectrophotometer. You can see the image which was developed by using image of fingerprint which was developed by using the gold nanoparticles. In conclusion, these new methods of developing latent fingerprints are considerably better than the conventional ones which are currently in use. This technique provide better rich details as compared to the traditional powder method. Therefore, nanotechnology plays a vital role in the development of latent fingerprints and can help the investigators in solving the cases successfully. Thank you.